Welcome, Shiva students. Students, today you will learn Chapter 20, Governing Ourselves of your Learning Aid Social Studies Book 5. Here, in this chapter, you will learn about the governing structure of India, governing bodies of India, and the formation of the government. But before learning the other details of the chapter, you should know what is government. So, government is the group of people with the authority to govern a country or a state, and a particular ministry in the office is called a government. The group of people with the authority to govern a country or a state and a particular ministry in the office is called a government. Our India is the world's largest democracy, and our government is run by the people of India. So, our government is of the people, for the people, and by the people. Before independence, India was having many small princely states which were ruled by Maharaja, Raja, Nabab, Nizam, Thakur, etc. After independence, the small Indian princely states were united to form an integrated India. So, what is the meaning of princely states? What do you mean by that? Princely states means the native states which were under a regional ruler who was forced to go under the control of the British government. So, after independence, our integrated India formed different states and union territories. Today, India has 28 states and 9 union territories to constitute the Indian Union, known as Republic of India. Republic of India. Now, you have to know the meaning of Republic of India. Republic of India means India became a free nation on 15th August 1947. And on 26th January 1950, the Constitution gave the citizens of India the power to choose their own government, which led India towards democracy. Understood? India follows a federal structure of governance. Means, a federal system of government is one that divides the powers of government between the national or federal government and state or local government. So, federal system means a federal system of government is one that divides the power of government between the national or the federal government and state or local government. So, in India, the central government and the governments of each state share the responsibility of running the country. In this way, the vast country like India runs with smooth functioning by these two divisions of government. One is state government and another one is central government. They have separate rights and responsibilities to run the whole system very well. One more important part you have to learn, students, and that is a vital part of functioning the government of our country is, it is a sovereign, secular, democratic republic. What do you mean by that? Sovereign, secular, democratic republic. Sovereign means supreme power or authority. That means India is a self-governing state. India is a self-governing state. Secular means not connected or not subject to or bound by religious rule. So, secularism in India means a state that supports or participates in a neutral manner in the affairs of all religious groups, not a particular religious group. Secularism in India means a state, means India is a state that supports or participates in a neutral manner in the affairs of all religious groups. Democratic Republic means our India is a state in which the supreme power rests in the hands of the citizens. Understood? So, students, today up to this, you listen the class very attentively. This chapter is little bit tough for you, but if you listen the class very attentively, not only this class, all the classes of this chapter, if you listen attentively, I'm sure that it will be easier for you to understand everything. Okay? So, have a nice day. I am ending my class here. Om Namah Shivaya.